Hi, my name is Tom Moore, and I'm going to talk to you today about the impact of international culture on the communication of an organisation in a multinational context. So I chose Saudi Arabia from the list I was given as the host country compared to us, being Ireland as the parent company. I chose Saudi Arabia as I believe is the country on the list with the most contrast for our own. Let's have just a quick look at the cultural differences between the two countries. So Ireland is predominantly Catholic. It's got a fixed nature of scheduling and punctuality. It's somewhat formal in regards to you can call your boss by your first name, or you say, "Hey Mike," instead of "Hey boss." It wouldn't be a problem. So it's somewhat fast decision making, depending on the organisation you're in question. Trade unions are legal, not a body being tried to trade union. Relations between manager and employee are based on a psychological contract. And your business and your personal life with your manager are usually kept separate. Now, in contrast to the host country, which is Saudi Arabia, it's a predominantly Islamic country, with the religion being Muslim. It's got a more relaxed nature to approaching scheduling. It's more approximate, like meeting at 2-ish. So it's usually based on the fact that their businesses, their business lives and their personal lives are very linked. So you can be a bit late, at least probably your dad. It's very informal compared to Ireland. You can't call your boss, "Hey Mike," it has to be either Sheikh, and it was Sheikh. I think it's just Sheikh. It's a relatively slow decision-making process, as their religion is a major part of their lives, and they usually leave it to to pray on it and look for guidance from their God. Trade unions are illegal in Saudi Arabia, very illegal. When the decision-making process is slow, patience is a virtue, a very, very important virtue, as impatience is a weakness in their country. As I said, relationships are based on their business and personal lives are very linked, so their relationships are based on mutual benefit and reciprocity of favours. So the cultural differences I've mentioned across there and really hinder communication. They really hinder communication within that country, let alone cross-border communication. So here we've got different work approaches between Ireland and Saudi Arabia. In Ireland, employees and employers work together to achieve organizational goals. Openness when talking to employers is encouraged, as long as it's in a relatively respectful tone. During peer reviews, you're allowed to assess your own and your employer's performance, and vice versa, employers allowed to assess their own and yours. During these peer reviews, you're allowed to openly comment, again as long as it's respectful, openly comment on how employers have helped or hindered an employee's performance. Now we look at the contrasting thing in Saudi Arabia. As you've seen over here, we're supposed to work together. In Saudi Arabia, employees are seen to work for employers to achieve their organisation goals. And challenging a senior is seen as insubordination within an organisation. Admitting faults leads to loss of credibility. Criticising an employer, whether it be constructively or just criticising an employer is seen as organisational suicide. And as we can see between the contrasting schemes between Saudi Arabia and Ireland, I do feel like Saudi Arabia is very hindering freedom of speech, which again really hinders communication, let alone cross-border communication. So now I'm going to talk to you about remedies and how to control cultural communication problems in the workplace. So there's two strategies that a company, an MNC, should incorporate into their strategy when dealing with cultural communications. There's a multi-domestic strategy, which has a high local responsiveness and a low global integration. And a transnational strategy has a medium local responsiveness and a medium global integration. But in this sense, seeing as Saudi Arabia has a higher difference to Ireland, the multi-domestic strategy should be one they're focusing on. They could also implement a cultural control, which along with the multi-domestic strategy, the MNC tries for global standardization and global responsiveness, which kind of incorporates the both and turns it into a transnational strategy anyway. There's another type of control, which is controlled through personnel. In this sense, the company can send their own employee from Ireland, which is the parent country, to the host country, which would be Saudi Arabia. There are many types of staffing, but in this sense, we're going to focus on polycentric staffing. We're going to focus on polycentric staffing because of the extreme cultural differences. Now, one thing you should realize, which kind of correlates with the cultural control and the organizational strategy, is that implementing this type of staffing, it decentralizes decision making, which takes decision making from the host country, from the parent country, and leaves it to the host country, which would be Saudi Arabia. This allows Saudi Arabia an autonomy in this sense. Implementing this type of staffing, the polycentric employee makes decisions to the extent to which the HQ allows. And if this is done correctly, these three remedies put into place with a good management staffing, the communication problems caused by the cultural differences shouldn't be a problem. That's good, thank you.